Welcome to NareshSai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In the last two videos, I did talk about what is abstract class and syntax of the abstract classes and usage of the abstract class and what is abstraction. And I told you like the rules of the abstract class. Especially in this video, I'm going to develop one program on top of class, interface, and abstract class and their relations. Now, generally I'm taking normal view program I'm taking here. Later in the next video, we'll see huge program related to classes and abstract class as well as what your interface. And now, here I'm taking one interface I. Here I have method like public abstract void m1 method, and one more method we have, that is public abstract void m2 method. Now I have one more interface. That interface name is j. If you want to make a relation between one interface to another interface, definitely we need to use one keyword, that is extends. We need to use one keyword, that is extends. Now in the j, I'm writing one more method, that is public abstract void m3 and public abstract void. No need to write public abstract every time. By default, these methods are public abstract only. Compiler will converting like that, meanwhile of compilation. Now here in the interface we have two methods. In the interface I we have two methods. In the interface J also we have what here? Two methods. See, by seeing there are two methods in the J, but in the background two more methods also there. They are coming from, they are extracting from, they are inheriting from what here? Interface I. Now I'm taking one class. I'm taking one class like L. That L class is trying to interact with the interface J. So there is one concept related to the interface, forcibility. If any class wants to communicating with the interface, that class must and should be provide the body for all the abstract method in that interface. That means if my L is communicating with the J, this L must and should be provide the body for M1 and M3 and M4. And in the background, two more methods are there. What are those? M1 and M2. So L must and should be provide the body for M1, M2, M3, M4. Now L is only providing the body for which method? M3 method. Providing the body for M3 method. So here I'm writing like one user friendly statement, that is system.out.println. This is what L class M3 method. L class M3 method. Nice. Now next one. So let me take one main method class, like that is a test. In the test class, I'm writing one main method, public static void main. And what is this? It's a string array, yes. And here I'm writing like test t equal to, what is that? New test. Test t equal to new test. So not required here, basically test t equal to new test we are not using. Just I'm taking the main method. Now let me compile the program, java c test.java. Now what happened? One beautiful error is given by the compiler. What is that? L is not abstract and not override abstract method. Which one? M4. So already I told you, if L is wants to interact with the interface J, that L must and should be provide the body for M1, M2, M3, M4. But in L, we are providing the body for only M3. So you guys know that class is only supports for what here? Providing implementation, nothing but holding the concrete methods, but it is not holding for abstract method. So maybe you guys are having the doubt like, sir, we didn't mention any abstract method here, then what is the wrong? So by syntactically, it will not visible whether the abstract methods we have or not. We have an abstract method. Why? L implements J. So J abstract methods are coming. J extends of I. So I methods also coming. In the background, we have M1, M2, M4. M1, M2, M4. Now, If I declared this class as abstract, Java C test.java, and later let me execute the program, but we are not getting any output, but execution purpose I'm showing. That means our program is successfully compiled and executes. Now, how to make a relation between abstract class to interface means by using what here? Implements keyword. Now, one more class I'm taking. What is that? Abstract class M extends of what? L. So, whatever the logic which we have in the L, whatever the functionalities are available in the L, those functionalities are coming to what here? M. Now, here I'm writing like a public void M4 method. Public void M4 method. Now, in the M4 method, I'm writing one user-friendly statement. What is that? System.out.println. This is M4 method. Good. Now, observe guys, in the M class, if you want to write M class related abstract methods, you can. If you want to write, here we need to write abstract keyword, otherwise compile time error. If you want to write any concrete method related to that particular class, you can write. So, in the abstract class, we can write their own abstract methods and concrete methods, and as well as we can able to provide the implementation for remaining abstract methods which are inheriting from either abstract class or interface. Now here I'm writing like system.out.println. This is M6 method. Good. Now observe guys. Now let me make a relation between class to abstract class. Here I'm taking like class N extends of what here? How to make a relation between class to abstract class by using what here? Extends keyword. Now totally how many abstract methods are there? 2, 4, and this is what here? 5. M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. So here in the L we are providing the body for M3. For M, we are M4 for purpose, we are providing the body for in M. So still we need to provide the body for what here? M1, M2, M5. So here I need to write the body for M1. And here I'm writing the body for M2. And here I'm writing the body for M5. Here I'm writing the body for M5. So for M1, another one is what here? For M2. And this is what here? For M5. Now, clearly observe. In the M1 method, I'm writing one statement. What is that? System.out.println n m1 method. System.out.println n m1 method. Now, let me copy this statement and paste here. Now, let me copy that one and paste here. Now, this is what m2 and this is what here? M5. And we need to remember one thing, end of the program and end of the all relation, we must and should be analyzed whether we are providing the body for all the methods or not. If you are not providing the body for any one of the method, we will get what here? Compile time errors. Now, so here I'm taking totally two interfaces, two abstract classes and two normal classes. So how to make a relation between interface to interface? Extends. How to make a relation between abstract class to interface? Implements. How to make a relation between abstract class to abstract class? Extends. And how to make a relation between class to abstract class? Extends. Okay. Now, here I'm writing like IOBJ. IOBJ equal to new N. The meaning of this program, the meaning of this statement, we'll see in the next video. So that is upcasting and downcasting and loosely coupling mechanism. We have superb videos, super topics we have. Those things I'm going to teach in coming videos. Now, as usual, whenever we calling any method, compiler always concentrate on reference variable type. Here my reference variable type is what here? OBJ. So compiler go and check M1 method in the OBJ type. What is the OBJ type? I. So M1 method is there. Compiler satisfy. And OBJ dot M2 method. Then compiler will go and check about M2 method in the reference type. What is the reference type here? I. So M2 method is there. Satisfy. Now JVM concentrate on memory. Here memory is what here? N. So M1 and M2 methods are executing from M1 and M2 methods are executing from N class. N class Java test. Good. Now if you're trying to write, OBJ dot M3. If you're trying to write OBJ dot M3, then what happened here? Observe here. Java C test dot Java and yes. What happened? Cannot find a symbol. The reason is compiler will go and check M3 method in the OBJ reference type. What is my OBJ reference type? I type. So compiler go and check M3 method in the I. There is no M3 method. That's why it will giving what here? Simply compile time error. Now, so how to load M3 and M4 method? Very simple. Let me go for what here? JOBJ1 equal to new N. Good. Now obj1 dot m3 method and obj1 dot m4 method. If you want to access obj1 dot m1 method, we can access, not a problem. Obj1 dot m2 method. Now, so here obj dot m3, obj1 type is what here? J type. J having m3 method? Yes. And m4 method? Yes. M1 and m2? No. If the M1 M2 method is not available in J, it will check about it's a super interface. What is the super interface for J? I. So M1 M2 is existed or not? So compiler satisfy. What is the JVM? JVM concentrate on memory. What is the memory here? N. So do you have M3 method in the N? No. Then control goes to it's a super class. What is the super class for N? M. Do you have any M3 method? No. And what is the super class for M? L. Do you have M3 method? Yes. So L class M3 method will be executes. L class M3 method will be executes. L class M3 method. Yes. Now, what is the next one? OBJ1 dot M4. OBJ1 type is what here? J type. Available? M4? Yes. So compiler satisfy. JVM concentrate on memory. What is the memory? N. So, do you have any M4 method? No. The control goes to it's a super of N. What is the N super? M4. Do you have? Yes. So, M class M4 method will be executing. Next one. What is that? OBJ1.M1 and OBJ1.M2. So, both are available in the N class. So, they are executing from what here? N class itself. But still, there are two methods which are available in the where? N as well as M. So how to use? So M, I told you like, see, we can able to create references for interfaces and references for what here? Abstract classes. References for interface and references for what here? Abstract classes. So what is the use of the references? So with the help of the references, we can able to hold either implementation class memory or subclass memory. Now here I'm writing like OBJ2 dot M5, good, and OBJ2 dot M6. So here compiler will check M5, M2, M6 method. Compiler will check for M5 and M6 within the where? OBJ2 type. What is the OBJ2 type? M type. So compiler go and check within the M class. Do you have M5 and M6? Yes. So compiler satisfy. But what about the JVM? JVM concentrate on memory. It will check about M5 method. Yes. N class M5 method is executing. But what about the M6? M6 is not available in the N. If the not available in the N, then control goes to where here? M class. Do you have M6 method? Yes. If yes means executes. Java C, test.java and Java test. So N class M5 and M class M6. So this is the way to developing a relation between interface to interface, abstract class to interface, abstract class to class, and one more thing is class to abstract class. This is what here has a relation. I hope you enjoy this video. In the next video, I'm going to talk about what is upcasting and downcasting. Very interesting and very important also in entire Java. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel.